So today I'm here for the monthly recommendations for the month of May. And the theme is books that I read because of BookTube. So these are books that I've seen through BookTube or I've seen other people read, and you know, it just made me want to read them. But most of the books that I have on my shelf, I read because of BookTube. But sometimes you see them on Instagram, sometimes you see them on Goodreads. You just hear people talking about them. So it's a bit hard sometimes to know what things made you read books. But I actually did this for a Top 5 Tuesday theme like a couple of months ago. So I'm going to use different books than I did for that, except for one. But just to let you know that I have done this before. So when I saw, oh, it's BookTube books, I was excited to see if there was more books that I thought were like books that I read because of BookTube. So let's get into the video. So the book that I'm using again is Because You Love to Hate Me by Emma Rowley, which is the anthology by a heap of authors that collaborated with BookTubers. So every single BookTuber that was a part of this talked the shit out of this book, man. And I was excited. Like, just the concept of it, like to have stories about villains, I was so excited. Like, yeah, some of them were better than others, and some of them you were a bit like, ah, yeah, okay then. But it was mainly a really good story, and I think you should read it because I actually enjoyed the BookTubers parts in this book, how they sort of talked about the reasons why they made the stories and just like their ideas for things. But I really enjoyed it and I just had a lot of fun with this book, and I totally recommend that you at least give it a try because it's like the ultimate BookTuber recommendation book. And the next book I'd like to talk about is Throne of Glass by Sarah J Maas, and I did read this book like probably 4 years ago. I don't know if it was 3 or 4, but I read this before BookTube, so it has to be more than 3, because like my 3-year anniversary is coming up in like the next couple of months. So like, the reason though is like, so I read this book before BookTube, but the thing is I didn't know what BookTube was until I saw one of Sasha Olsberg's videos. So BookUtopia, I saw one of her videos and she mentioned this book, but I never thought that people like talked about books this way. Like, the things that I was reading was like Cassandra Clare's books and like Vampire Academy, Bloodlines and the Fallen series, like all the generic like series. Like, I did love reading, but I didn't really reach out there for like a lot of different books until BookTube. But that really widened my horizon on the fact that there was actually so many fucking books out there that you can read, so many different genres. So Throne of Glass I've read beforehand, but I saw it on a YouTube channel and I picked it up because it was in my local bookstore, which never has books, had Throne of Glass, and I was just like, what? I read it and I loved it. And this is just one of those like books, how I talk about how I've like, you know, read this and it leads you into being like, woo, this is that book for me. And that's why I love Throne of Glass so much, because I read this. I was probably 6 months later that I actually started my BookTube, and I would mention this book a lot because I was so excited. But I recommend it. I mean, everyone's probably read it, but I recommend it for like that BookTube reference. Okay, next book I'd like to recommend is The Problem with Forever by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I'm pretty sure I saw Katie Tasty talking about this book and I was obsessed with the cover. Like, I had to put it on the list because like, it was on YouTube, and with everyone making it look really nice in the videos, I was like, damn. And I love Jennifer L. Armentrout as well, so I had to get this book as well. But this is just one that the cover drew me in so much, and just then I heard about the story and then people just kept mentioning it, and I'm like, I have to. So the next book I'd like to recommend is Anna and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins. And this is a book that I saw everyone recommend on YouTube for like a start to contemporaries, because Anna and the French Kiss and like this trilogy is just like the stepping stone, like the starting point of so many people reading young adult contemporary. Like, this is like, if you haven't read this trilogy, who are you? Like, how do you even read contemporary if you haven't read the ultimate of contemporary? And like, this is something that I just kept saying because like, I never read contemporary. Like, I could not stand it. I honestly could not sit through a book when nothing was happening, even though things were happening. Nothing fantasy, nothing sci-fi, nothing actually like cool. It was just people with relationship dramas. And I was like, fuck that, not gonna read it. And now I love contemporary, and I honestly feel like sometimes I love contemporary more than fantasy, and it's just like, like, what, who am I? But yes, like, I just totally recommend it because you just, it's not the best story, but it's just, ugh. The next book I'd like to recommend is A Red Queen by Victoria Aveyard. Again, with A Throne of Glass, this was one of those ones that I saw recommended, and I saw it on Book Depository and I bought it, and I loved this book, and the series just went downhill from there. But still, this book really got to me when I first started, and like, I think I bought The Night Circus at the same time as this book, but it was actually just a Book Depository recommendation. I'm just like, yeah, I'll get The Night Circus. Might like that book, maybe. My favorite, but I literally just loved Red Queen so much, and like, the story was interesting, and yes, there is a gazillion tropes, every trope you can think of somewhere in this series, but she does it so well, like honestly so well. And this book is so little that it's so easy to get through. Like, I can't believe the next one's that's like so massive, but like, loved it. Next I'd like to recommend is Fangirl. I'm so scared when I do that because I like got a cut from my cat and my thumb on my thumb. I got a cut from my cat on my thumb and it hurts every time I touch it. It hurts every time I move. I'm trying to do my video and I'm just like a cripple because my thumb hurts. But the book is Fangirl by Rainbow Rowell. And like again, with Anna and the French Kiss, this is like the next book you should read, because if you're a fangirl and you want to read contemporaries, mate. I actually didn't buy this book for like the longest time. Like I really wanted to read it, but I just never bought it. And there's so many books like that where I don't buy them because I have too many. And there's so many that I just want to buy and I can't. And like, but this is one that I did buy and I'm so glad. This is one of my favorite contemporaries because I just relate so much to Kath and I just recommend it because this book was just amazing. Like if you haven't read it yet, you need to. And the last book I'd like to recommend is Stalking Jack the Ripper by Carrie Maliscalco. And again, Sasha Olsberg got me with this book. I was obsessed with Sasha Olsberg at one point. Like I loved her videos, but after she went to Scotland and had college and she started getting really obsessed with Zenith, I've kind of really backed away from her because she doesn't really read anymore and all she reads is Scottish fiction and like it's just kind of all boring. Like, and Zenith was like a cool point, but like I mean it's just all she talks about now is Zenith and it's just like all she talks about her dogs. Like, not that like it's a bad thing, but so back in the day I loved her recommendations and I always was picking up the books that she was reading. But to sum up, I don't watch her anymore because she just kind of irritates me. But yes, this is a book that I saw on her channel and I was obsessed with the idea of this, but I was kind of scared because it was about like opening up bodies and shit and I was not here for it. Stalking Jack the Ripper was freaking me out, but like then I decided to buy it because the book was like 16 bucks and I was like, mate, that's what you want. But I was really excited and I did read it and I loved it. But Hiding from Houdini is still like 4 or 5 months away and I'm dying. I need to know. I need so many books coming out too and they're getting pushed back and I just need to know what's happening. But this is one that I definitely got the recommendation from YouTube and people need to read this book because like it needs the hype. Like people need to read it. Like it needs hype. It needs more people reading it. It's amazing and I just, you know that I feel in it because I'm like screaming at you right now, but just pick it up. So here are the 7 books I'd like to recommend you now, but I pretty much should just do like a bookshelf tour if you want all of my BookTube recommendations because that is all the books that are sitting right there. But anyway, guys, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed and I'll see you guys later. Bye!